present.
Hello there.
And I know others here are representatives of the elementary.
I saw you in Kansas City, sir, about 2 weeks ago. We appreciate that speech. It was excellent.
Well, thank you very much. Please. I'm sorry that your colleagues from the National Education Association can't be here. They were invited and chose not to come. I guess they're marching to a different drum. Welcome all of you here, and I think you know that we want to do everything we can to help in the implementation of many worthwhile recommendations in the Commission on Excellence in Education. Done a little traveling in that regard lately. The press, of course, described it as purely political. It isn't. I've been concerned about education from the time the state superintendent of my state told me that he could not recommend a city or a school in our capital, in our state capital, that he could recommend I send our 8-year-old son to. And I thought something like that needs some help. I understand that, and I hasten to add that I understand that the situation has been, to a degree, corrected. There are some schools doing a fine job in Sacramento now. So,
well, Mr. President, we invited these leaders of our national education organizations here to have a conversation with us. I've heard many of them express their appreciation for all that you've been saying about education and calling the attention of the nation, actually, to the problems that were identified in the National Commission report. And I indicated when we extended the invitation that we would welcome, if it's all right with you, that they just raise some questions and start a conversation with us. So it's okay, Mr. President, with this?
It sure is. I really came in to listen, not talk.
Hi, President, I'm with the National Association of Elementary School Principals. I'm the Executive Director. This is Phil Jenkins, our President of the Association. He's an online elementary principal. As a result of your initiative.
Mayor Martinez.
President, how are you?
Mayor, how are you? Mr. President, how are you doing?
Yeah, we saw you.
Good. My President. Yes, all right. Good to see you. You good?
Want a quick one?
Oh, great, too.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good.
Listen, I stood where you now stand one time.
Well, I think there's three, right?
I changed two.
Tommy, how are you?
Tommy, too.
How are you doing?
Yeah, Henry Taylor.
Nice to see you.
From a distance the other night at the.
How about that?
We were trying to clap as hard as we were. You were giving us a hard time.
But I couldn't tell whether it was you or General Kelly that was making the most noise. But it was great.
Wasn't that a wonderful
thing?
Wasn't
that
great?
This was the best I've ever heard. It was at the Kennedy Center.
Is it an annual conference?
Well, this was for the 185th birthday with us. But I can confirm what you said, because in a box with us is a man who was the director of the Marine Band from
30s or some sound.
Something like 19. Well, anyway, yes, and up till
mid-50s.
1955, 15 years. But before him, there was one other band director, and before that one was his father, this man's father, who was, well, between the two of them, they have been the directors of the band for 45 to 100 years. And he said to us this was the greatest Marine band he had ever heard.
Oh, it was
the acoustics, and wasn't that fantastic when the trumpets, they had the trumpets up in the balcony. Placing
them all throughout the hall.
It was just fantastic.
Never mind that. We've got quite a record there.
We've got a great community, so it's not too hard to get involved with it.
No, and we're more than proud that you did.
26. He likes your program, Mr. President. That's
we've been able to do quite well with it, and we believe we're a self-sufficient city and have moved forward.
Beautiful city.
Have real good growth, and unemployment is under 8. So we're in good shape.
How about that?
A lot of growth.
He's eager to work at your reelection.
And we're quite prepared to do so, and looking forward to it.
Well, here's a little.
Sure, thank you. Appreciate it very much.
Thank you.
Thank you much.
Sure, appreciate your time.
Pictures with these fellows.
Oh, yeah, that would be nice.
First time going to bat for a Republican was 1960.
Is that right?
Then I was still a Democrat. I stayed there. I was in 62.
Mr. President, we get a couple photos here.
Mr. President, you still have a good luck charm?
We wanted to show you.
Good match, bud.
That works.
Thank you.
Well, you brought a request from a bunch of folks in town.
That's correct. We, as you know, the host city, the Super Bowl is coming here, and we certainly love to have you there. And we'll make you feel very welcome down in Hospitality. And you'd honor us very much if you can make it, and certainly do all that's necessary.
Now that's not the one that's there, because the Super Bowl is later.
It's later. It's January 22nd, I believe.
Just before the start of the other football season.
Yeah, right. You better go back 2 months before the primary. So I tried it. And we're going.
Well, I hope I can. I'd love that. I like football.
Well, I'm sure we can arrange for it, and we've got some real nice sky boxes here as well that I think working with your security people can all be worked out real well.
I was going to say, because normally the Secret Service would want the stadium cleared.
Thank you, sir.
You're
going to
ask
what
position you're going to play.
But we also urge you to seek re-election. I know that you have a lot of thinking to do about that, but folks back home sure appreciate it if you would.
Well, no, thank you very much. I can't answer that.
We understand that, but we stand ready.
Well, listen, have you re-registered yet?
Not yet. I'm going home to have dinner with my wife, and of course she makes those decisions with me.
Well, I tell you, there's a lot of things you can think about in making it sensational. When I finally, I'd campaigned, as I said, in 60. Now, 62, you're campaigning. I'm at a Republican fundraiser, and a woman stood right up in the middle of the audience and said to me, "Have you re-registered?" And I said, "Well, no, but I intend to." She said, "I'm a registrar." She walked right down the center, put the thing on the podium, and I registered right there. She said, "Now, where was I?"
Mr. President, we know you're busy, so God bless you.
Thank you for your time. I appreciate it very much.
Pleased to meet you. And
George, we know you're busy, too. I can look at you, too.
Well, I know we've interrupted something here. I came in to listen, not to talk, except to again thank you all. Good to see you.
You know, Mr. President, how about having one of these meetings down in California one of these days?
At the ranch.
That'd be fine anywhere in California.
I'd like that. Any excuse to get there.
Mr. President, the focus for this meeting, we have the broad general topic of managing the recovery.
See you. I'm having a short answer. President, I know. Very nice to see you. Would you stand back a little bit?
Hello, how are you?
I'd like to
present
that
Congratulations,
Mr.
President. Mr. President, I have something for you. This is my son, Jason Lee Middleton.
Hi, Jason. I'm not going to get much attention with those heels.
Mr. President's here. it's a gold miner's camp. She's from Alaska. Mr. President?
Well, you went down, you got to sit there. You can't run around. Let me give your speech, okay? Prospecting for gold was what brought the greatest thrust of settlers to Alaska. And gold is the biggest. It helped it, show you some of the great state that it is today. Your help and assistance. A genuine prospector's pen, unlike the one that was used originally, created at the Klondike Gold Strike. And moved all the way back in 1896. And right now we from the National Multiple Sclerosis Society are planning for another reason, and that's for the cure for multiple sclerosis, particularly for young adults. And we appreciate all the help that you have given us, and we, from the whole national, from the nation's Multiple Sclerosis Society, that you're alerting all the nation and the people of this great country to that fact, and so that we can find a cure for this crippling disease.
I hope the society finds
the cure.
The gold.
Yes,
the
but
cure.
You can for the gold. Thank you.
And we all do this.
Yes.
And I have for you a plaque regarding
you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Camera?
That would be something I'll cherish the rest of my life.
A souvenir.
Oh, thank you so much. That was great. Thank you so much. You're doing a great job. I send my regards to everyone in my
school. Congratulations. Very pleased and honored to have you here. Congratulations on your having been selected.
Hi, I'm Janet.
Mr. President, so nice to see you again.
Mr. President, how are you?
I'm Sylvia Laurie.
These girls wrote the nominating letter, you see, and that's very important.
Yes.
And I can nominate. Now, this young lady is freshman in college, and she is considering majoring in economics.
Stop right there. Stop.
You have some encouragement.
My own degree was in economics. And, I have a story, but it might discourage you. It's a story that has to do with three gentlemen arriving at the gates of heaven, and St. Peter had to tell them there was only room inside for one, and they had decided to take whichever one had practiced the oldest trade or profession. And one stepped forward and said, "Well, I guess that's me." He said, "We know that the Lord created Adam, and then with a rib from Adam created Eve." And he said, "I'm a surgeon." He must have been a surgeon, so that's the oldest. But before he could move in, second, I said, "Just a minute." Before that, all was chaos. And the Lord spent 6 days working to eliminate the chaos before he made Adam. So he must have been an engineer. And he said, "I'm an engineer." And as he started to move, the third one said, "Wait a minute. I'm an economist. Where do you think they got all that chaos?"
Mrs. Peel, you want to take that, Mrs. Peel?
Yes.
This is a plaque for you as Father of the Year. And
thank you very much.
And these are a set of cupcakes as a souvenir.
Well, thank you very much.
Mr. President, we need to get a picture of just you and the two recipients here. So,
The Japanese prime minister was here, and he was sitting over those chairs, and three waves of press photographers, three groups, because they couldn't go to India, couldn't go to those cameras, and he was just absolutely motionless. And when they left, I found out why. He'd been counting the Japanese cameras.
Very well. Pleased to see.
Well, he's a very strong guy. I'm sure it's what you believe. Keep on paying for that goal. For him.
Okay. This is for you. Jason, you want to?
This is a jar with the seal on it and my name engraved on it. But inside the jar are jelly beans.